Welcome back, everybody, to our Armed and Stinky campaign of Warhammer Total War. In this game, you are my Senate, and you make choices as to what to do, so let's get started. Empress Patches is on my lap here, wondering what the heck's going on, why I'm yelling at a screen. Our Senator Ewigman, again, is giving us suggestions, and his suggestion was to take this commander and go and reconquer the Silver Road. While meanwhile, we have this army right down here. He has a big question. Does he go and conquer, or does he go and protect the city? Now, Senator Yeogman's suggestion was, if this army is large, to go and protect this city, but if it's small, to push forward. Well, it's 13. That's a hard question as to whether it's large or small. I'd say it's medium-sized, so it's really kind of neither. But, you know, if I go forward, I'm going to be stuck in a siege for a while, and I think over 10 probably is good enough to call it large. So, I'm going to send him here. It suddenly occurred to me, I can't move through the mountain pass here, because if you look here, the reason why I can go straight from the city into the mountain pass is it's connected to the mountain, and you can actually see the entrance there. Whereas here, not connected to the mountain. So that kind of sucks, so I'm going to send him to the mountain. Rather than sending him all the way around, I'm actually going to send him up to the mountain here. And so next turn he can go through the mountain pass, and that way he's still close enough to go and protect this city at the moment. I really want to put some people here to protect it, but we're so close to bankruptcy. So you know, here's what I'm going to do. I am going to... I'm going to send this guy... Oh, that's right, he can't move yet. Oh, that's because we still have... Okay, you haven't even said the group of 18, so in other words, go now, conquer! So we're going to go and conquer. Actually, you know what? Then I shall build right down here, and I am going to recruit a lord down here. Spurned. Leadership plus two. Oh, we don't want to lose public order. We've been having a problem with that. Zanil Whitebeard, who is humble. All right, we shall have the humble man. We shall recruit him. All right, we're starting to run low on money. Oh, let's definitely put him inside the city. He can lead... You know what? I'm going to have him lead the... there's the Winds of Magic. I'm going to have him lead the garrison for now, and next turn I'll start giving him an army. Meanwhile...
One rug.
That's right.
Destroy them!
Alright. Auto resolve. We'll just run right over them. Aha! Alright. Remaining zero. And let's occupy it.
The runes are cast!
Let's see. Banner gained. War banner. Oh, it looked like the Confederate flag there for a second. The war banner is an age-old standard that has been sacked with blood and battle, a testament to endless war. Leadership of plus five. All right, it's now in the unit. And now if we just keep conquering, we'll just keep making money. But you know what? I'm going
to
leave him there. I'm going to slowly move my way up each turn. Not slowly, but each turn take a new place. And I'm going to wait for him to go over there. So, Grunderdrak, I should relearn these names. I'm going to wait for Grunderdrak of the Valley.
Oh, our honored dwarfkin.
All right, what's up? They're off to join the war against the Vampire Council. You know, I really want to do these things with you, and if I could just bring you into my fold as, like, you know, part of my group, then I would just basically make that as a counteroffer, but I can't make that. So, you know what? Sorry, I can't do it right now. Oh, good. Hey, cool. The princes are sticking up for us. Winds of Magic change. All right, well, we don't care about magic. Dwarf technology, dwarf treasuries. All right. Oh, rebellion imminent. Yeah, because of all this disorder. All right, well, let's take care of that right now. Let's go through the Underdark.
Grudges will be settled.
Can we go into the city? No. Oh, it's because they're sieging it, so... And can
time
we now
for
move...
A reckoning.
Shoot, we have to stop there, and then we'll go after next turn. But at least the princes are helping us. We're going to have a rebellion, probably, but that's... Somehow our rebellion is always goblins, so, which is kind of odd. But anyway, we're going to buy some more units here, but let's first conquer some more territory to make some more money.
To battle!
Yeah, all right, auto-resolve that bitch. Yep. And occupy.
I agree.
Follower gain. Cooper. We'll call him Coop. Income from breweries and gym cutters, plus 6%. Nice. Followers ready to be assigned to a character of your choosing. Follower gained, archivist. Research rate plus 10%, nice. Province secured, alright. Grudge successful. And we got more money. All right, so now we have more people. I'm definitely going to build them into here. Oh, we need some quarrelers, but you know, we're going to get one thing of quarrelers. I hate to spend this much. Oh boy, it's a lot of money to spend.
Yes.
All right, we're going to do that for now. We're in a bit of trouble, but we're going to do it.
Good.
Yep.
Grimnir's axe first.
Okay, he's waiting there for the time being. I do need to look at what we have, because it's a sigil sword, enhanced shield, Charlotte Chair, war banner. Oh, two war banners, and archivist, banner of swiftness. All right, so we have two war banners. I wonder if that actually matters. All right, I think we're filled with all of our people. Let me make sure of that, though.
For the wisdom of Valea.
Jewelsmith, is there anybody? Oh, Cooper is... Ah, here we go. Income from these guys, since Dragonslayer is watching over. It's funny, because his name is Dragonslayer. Oh, here we go. Spell Shield. Well, I'm going to give that to the guy who's going to go out and conquer. But it's funny, his name's Dragonslayer, so it seems like, oh, he's going to be the guy who goes out and fights, but he's so good at keeping order that it's better for him to stay there. So, we're going to give it to Whitebeard. We're going to give, what was it, one of the things we just saw, the Spell Shield. And, ooh, we have these. Warrior Bane. What would this do? Weapon damage, sword of might. Oh yeah, what does it do? The sword of might is, oh okay, weapon strength plus 6%. Warrior Bane, I think it scares the enemy or something like that. You know what? Sword of might, we already have a sword of might. It'd be neat to have them have different weapons. Passive ability, Warrior Bane. Instantly affects targets in an area, constant around self, affects enemies in range. And, yeah, it like scares them. This instilling weapon spreads a curse all around, dispersing enemy warriors of their martial skills. Nice. Alright. Anybody who's not assigned? You know what? I wonder if the war banner, leadership plus 5, leadership plus 5, he's already got one, so I'm going to give it to him. Actually, you know what, though? He might need the war banner. He's got a master rune, grudge, yeah, he's got quite a few things. Basic armor. We'll wait for the next thing for him to come in. Fencer's blades, talisman. Yeah. That's alright. He's good. Alright. Let's go with the next technology. Let's see. I do want all of the cities to grow faster. But we need to take them first. So actually, I'm going to do this. We need money, too, but... Income from that's from a specific place, and that's a hero cost, and I'm not going to do either right now. So...
Yes.
Can he go in yet? No, that's next turn, huh? All right, next turn then. Oh, maybe to show commandment. Oh, that's right. He gets a commandment. So we need more money. Well, you know what I'm going to do is I'm going to make my money by just conquering some more territories. Growth. I think I want my new places to grow quickly. So that's what I'm going to do. Growth. Characters on a skill point. Oh, this is one of the was engineer. Yeah. Additional tradable resources produced. Yeah, let's do that. Here's a Grudge Bearer. Grudge Bearer. Mr. Grudge Bearer. You know, these are kind of like the big kingly type things. Leadership and missile resistance. I'm going to do obdurate. He's stubborn. And the dwarves like that. So it increases his leadership. The Emperor's Patches is sacked out on the left.
Dowie, it is an honor.
See, they really want us to enjoy that war. Well, we have just taken this area, so they're gonna. I know they're gonna come down here, but you know what? Here, I'll do this. Add an offer payment. Demand payment of 1,200, because that's what it's gonna cost. Oh, their economic power is weak. I'm gonna say 900. All right, join me. They've accepted. Wow, they were desperate. Yeah, and here they come. Oh, good grief. Seriously? So he's there, and they... Oh, man. So they're going to kill him. Yeah, you don't have a chance to retreat. Wow. Well, one of the things that Yeugman said he wanted me to do... Oh, here we go. Nutter, dwarves. Okay, he was with the garrison. I was going to build up. Oh, they haven't. He hasn't built his army yet. One of the things Eugman said, though, was play the battle out and take out as many of them as possible. So I shall do it with our new leader. And I did give him, I think, a banner or something like that, so... Well, shoot, it's just... This is getting frustrating, because... Maybe I just need to build an army, like, where they can't touch me and then bring it in. Because the thing is, it's just like, I send one army south, they attack the north. Go to the north, they go to the south. So it's just, like, back and forth. So here's a question. I could put the miners up in their face and just attack their, archers. However, their archers will probably run behind their main force, and I'll just lose the miners. I mean, it's sort of a suicide mission regardless, but I would be losing, you know, splitting up the force. So, you know what? I am going to find some hills here. Here we go. I'm going to go behind these hills. Yeah. And he'll, these guys will watch. See what's going on. There we go. So he can see them. The leader will be in the middle of them. And you'll have the miners on one side and the... warriors on the other, and we will make our stand, even though it's fruitless. I'm surprised it doesn't let us retreat. Alright, well at least they're going to have to go a long way, so hopefully they'll come in a little bit more exhausted. I'm basically behind this thing here because they have a lot of archers, so you know, it's to make it so they have to come up into our faces. Alright, they're just coming up at us evenly here. Ready! Run! Now, as soon as they start shooting, I'm gonna come running back. There we go.
Nothing can stop us!
Nothing can stop us from running away from you! Run! Archers are coming at ya! Ah, a lot of arrows landed on the ground there, all around them. Okay, you know what? Get over here, maybe. Any special abilities? Nope. This is really pretty annoying that, just can't get our, because we're gonna lose this and we're gonna lose that leader.
Ready to serve! Minus!
Run. So basically, our goal is to just kill as many of them as possible. Oh, they can see us? That's annoying. Alright, you're gonna go out, but I want you to go out in style. So when they go up for the jump ball, pull down their pants. Point to anybody who knows where that's from. Oh, you guys, you need to be running there. What's his name again? Whitebeard? He's humble. So humble, he will... Oh, there we go. He doesn't even want into the fight. Then he might have to take the glory for it. Off we go, then. Just fight wherever you are, guys. Take out as many as you can. You will be remembered. Schools will be named after you. And little kids will complain about having to go to the place named after you. Oh, man, he's way into that banner there. Oh, nicely done there, Whitebeard. Now humbly kick their asses. Well, if they would survive after this, I'd be like, hey, send all of them to escape. So everybody but the leader. Can he retreat? No. just go until he dies. That really sucks. Oh, now he flees. Yep. Oh, a great leader. Whitebeard. I'm not sure how other people do it, because I've seen how other people had, like, an extra army to kind of deal with this, but... I mean, in Let's Plays, but... how, you know, economically, every time I do that, I go bankrupt, so... not exactly sure how this is supposed to work. Okay, yeah, there is a... kill in battle, Whitebeard. Zamnil Whitebeard, we hardly knew he... settlement sacked. Grudge issued. Okay, here we go. So, a reckoner has approached, requiring guidance on how to settle a dispute between two clans. Both are claiming ownership of a mine. One has remained loyal to you for centuries, and the other has opposed many of your edicts. Mine dispute. Give it to the loyalist clan. Come from iron mines, gold mines, and stone quarries with plus 10%. Or we give it to the opposing clan, who we just helped by joining their war. If we, diplomatic relations would go up, but we're kind of ticked at them for getting us into a war with the, undead, so I'm gonna give it to the loyalists. Raiding, yeah, I know.
Good.
Alright, now is the big question.
Axe first.
Do we bring Grudgebearer? Do we have him guard this area from, you know, them coming up, or do we come bring them down to help down here? You know what I think I'm going to do? I'm going to build that extra army up here, because up here, in fact, actually, I could just do it under, oh, I don't know why I didn't do this first time. Well, I guess it's because I was wanting it to be an army from here, but I'm going to build it under Dragon Slayer.
Put
them back in there. Okay, so he's going to rebuild another army for fighting here, and Grudgebearer is going to go through the mountain. Can he just go right now?
I agree.
Yeah, to down here, and I'm going to come up behind them, take this, and then come down here from behind him. Ha ha! Ha ha!
It is time!
Yes, it is time. Hopefully we won't get taken down here. I really do. I need, like, an extra army here to defend here, an extra army here to defend here, and then I can go forward with these guys. Okay, so he's not going to go through the Underdark anymore. He's going to go...
by the Grudgebearer's will.
Okay, do I go attack this one, or do I go attack these guys? Rebels or that? You know what? There, I'm going to hold off on that for a second.
Time for a reckoning.
Oh, I might make money, actually, so I'm going to wait on this.
Of Valea.
I think... you know what? I'm going
to... such orders.
I'm going to guess you're going to go after these guys, because you came up while they were here, whereas these guys, these other... I'm going to guess you're going after the princes are going after them, because these guys just appeared, and these guys were already coming up here before these guys existed, so
it's
I'm going to go get
time.
The rebels first.
Drink.
We're turning into goblins. All right, just run over them. I'm killing them now. I'm just so sick of this.
Right.
Oh, I can keep on going? I can finish them off, or I can take the city. Let's see, how many of them are left? Only six?
Summon me, if you dare!
Is there anybody in there? Barak... oh no, this is... Doc Karaz? Do we know what's in there? No. I think we can take it. I'm gonna take it. Oh yeah, let's run right over it. I think this is part of our thing. We could just raise it. Oh, but then they just go and rebuild it. So, you know what? I'm going to occupy it.
Both
down. Raising Drim Cutters. All right, we got a Cooper. More money? All right. Good.
The axe thirsts for war.
It does. You know what? I'm going to try diplomacy one more time with the princes. They're kind of snobs, but...
Do not greet me as a friend, nor are we foes yet.
Man, they're just dicks. Non-aggression pact, huh? It's going to be really hard to get. I mean, I'd like to offer something, but I really just can't spend much money I needed to build my army. So, yeah, of course. All right, screw you guys. Is anybody else we're not allied with over here?
Welcome, Dowie. Do you bring a gift of Gromril to aid in negotiations?
Alright, let's at least get a non-aggression pact. Alright, cool. Now these guys, I'm trying to think, actually... Oh, I see, I have to offer to them these things. I can't do it as a counteroffer. Oh, and they're pissed at me because of the mine. Okay. I can't do military access because, hey, we can't go to the, you know, I can't go and attack the, the undead without military access, so, haha. But you know what? Okay, I'm going to build up my relations with them from now on because I do want that. Alright. And he's moved already. And so he's going to start building up his army.
Go on, then.
That'll be it for now. Character has an unassigned skill point. Gradadrak, alright. Let's see here. See, I've been actually using him to actually fight. Although, let's see. Corruption. Construction cost. Okay, we do want that. But... Absolute charge bonus. Accurate hit points. Missile resistance. Obdurate leadership. You know, I'm going to do Axe Lord. Do you have damaged buildings? Okay, yeah, we're not going to repair that until it's secure. Screw it! Oh, boy. Here come the vampire counts. What the heck? A Craven Raider. Dwarf trade caravan is, ringed by goblin wolf riders. Stalemate has developed, but the foe refuses to relent. Such a local affray should be dealt with by local lord, but your intervention could speed things up. Leadership plus 5, all forces. Public order negative 3 in all... Well, okay. Or you're on your own, the raid remains. Leadership of negative 5, but public order goes up by 3. We do need some public order. But we are trying to win the day. We're trying to conquer some places. So you know what? I'm going to do this. Public order will go down a little bit, but... Yeah, I know. We're already getting hit with a lot of public order.
Time for a reckoning.
What is this guy doing? Just the one guy... Oh, it's one of their characters. And what the heck happened to the princes? Why? Oh,
no.
Just riding by.
I ain't doing that.
Alright.
Yes. Well,
you know what? Screw it. I'm gonna bring this guy over and
kill
them
off. Let's settle this.
Just run over them. Kill them off.
Forward.
Enemy killed in battle. Alright, got some more money. Enchantment gain. Oh, Crown of Command! Ooh. Crown of Command has been worn in countless battles. Its wearer is given great authority, instilling in its subjects an unbreakable courage. You know what? I'm gonna leave it here, and he is the King of the Valley, so... A dwarf bride, and he has a dwarf bride to go with his crown. So he's king and queen. Income from all buildings plus 9% for the local region.
What?
Nice. I like it. I like what's happening to Grundadrak. Now here's the question: do I run back and finish this guy off, or do I leave him to the prince, hope that the prince takes care of him, and bring him up here? You know what? Yogvin did say something about cutting them off from behind. So here's what I'm actually going to do. I'm actually going to put a Grundadrak by the mountain over here.
Got them.
That way, and then what I'm going to do...
Beards in belts.
Let's see. Then what I'm going to do is, if the prince doesn't take care of that goblin, then I will use the mountain to come back. But if he does, then I'll just continue on over here. So I shall... Yeah, I'll leave him there. Oh, yeah, and then the king...
One rug!
Oh, yeah, that's right. Raiding stance in camp. Okay, just regular. Take this. I'm not playing these battles because it's just like it's... I can run over them, and why not? Just finish them off. Occupy. Actually, do I want to just loot? The problem is I keep having to deal with a lot of instability. And I don't want to just leave things behind me. I want to conquer them, so... Talisman gained. Luckstone! Nice! 8 times any rate. Alright, grudge successful. Gain 1,000. making lots of money. Alright, that means more of an army. Okay. Leave that. Sounds a little like the soundtrack to, Civilization. Alright, maybe that's how they do it. Just keep, stay on the conquering. Stay on the offensive. Just keep on conquering. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna bring the king back down around here. Take them from behind, have him take this, and that will cut them off wherever they are. I don't know, you know, how supplies necessarily deal, but at least we'll have them cut off from their base supply. Then Grundadrak will retake his realm while the king goes on the offensive. So that's what we're gonna be doing. Character doesn't anything. Grundadrak! Alright, he's gonna be conquering, he's gonna be fighting. Don't need to worry about that. We need to fight. Ammunition plus 3 for quarrelers, thunders, grid star units, okay. I'm saying vigor, loss reduction small. Arms of the Deep, leadership plus 3 during subtraining. He's going to actually be in the battle. Hit points plus 6%. Alright. Scared has an intense healing. Grudge Bearer. Nice. Although we want to give him the last of these. Missile resistance 10%. Willed. Recovery time. Lightning Strike. I'm just thinking if I need to start bringing these up. I'm going to keep building them up on this. Melee Defense. Longbirds, Hammers, Iron Breakers. Our size. Plus 10%. There we go. And you have buildings required. Okay, no, we're not going to repair that. However, one thing I do need to start doing is once I've built up a large enough army with this guy, I need to start building up my building here so I can start building those, choppers, because those choppers are going to be necessary. But let's keep going. Oh, bringing the army over, or just a character, maybe. Oh, seriously? You're attacking me with that, huh? Oh, and the underway. That's interesting. Well, you know what? We're getting close to the end of this, of today's game, and we really haven't fought any... Well, you know what, though? I want to do a more important one. I mean, this one's just... I'm going to run over them, so screw it. And I might screw it up. That's one thing I'm a little worried about. I'd rather our... You know, if we have one battle, I'd rather it be something a little more important. So, alright, Opal Amulet. Nice. XP gain. Nice. And execute them captives. Oh, yeah, you better go run.
High King.
Oh, hi.
I will hear you beg now.
Yep. Peace treaty. Payments. I owe Payas to have a peace treaty. Sure. We don't want to be at war with you anyway. I know the others will be kind of ticked at us, but we're... Oh, grudge successful. It was Greenskin Grudge. Beheld by a wrathful Grimnir, the old enemy, a Greenskin mob has sacked a Dwarfhold. The rage is deep. Oh, okay, they... Defeat the falling lord's army by spat. You know, I haven't even read these
your
anymore.
Conquests strike fear into the hearts of your enemies, mighty lord.
Oh, cool.
The wisest amongst them will know that fate is on your side. I have foreseen it.
All right. Hostile hero activity. Block army failure. Nice. Rating, yeah. Talisman gain. Given to Grundadrak, which is great. Opal amulet. And his wife's probably wearing it. Invest in the guild's workshop treasury. Wait, what? Start of your turn, have a treasury of 10,000. Oh, wait. Invest in the guild's workshops. The Engineers Guild have some new designs for an exciting improvement to the gyrocopter, which would allow for increased speed. Oh, okay, so I want to get the ability to build those then. Oh, okay, so build and conquer more places. All right, Axe of Grimnir. A dwarf is never content to part with gold, but the upgraded workshops will allow this labor to proceed. Oh. Okay. So I automatically got it? I don't understand. Okay, so that's the quest is issued. Have two of any of the following units. Gyrocopter, gyrobomber, gyrocopter. Okay, the following Lord's Army. Okay, well, yeah, I need to get those. I do need to build up to that, but it's just like, look at our economy, and look at our places. We need another army so we can go conquer these places.
For right. The wisdom
looks
of
like
Valaya.
The prince has scared those goblins off, so we're going to come conquer this. Alright, we're going to create a siege. Yeah, I find the battering ram less important. I'm going to build at least two of those, then I'll do a battering ram. Alright, so he will set siege to that. Continue the siege.
Axes.
So he's doing that, while Grudgebearer will start just going around conquering their territory. Oh, Iron Rock. Alright, screw it. We're going to come down here into Iron Rock.
Bring them!
Oh, crap. I should have just used the underway. I'm an idiot. Well, hopefully I'm right by the mountain. Next turn I can probably get there. And I had just conquered that, hadn't I? I meant to have everybody stop and rest every time I do this. Oh, well. You know, also, I probably should build up to 20 as well. Oh, well. All right. Building's repaired. It's funny, as I was saying, he should probably build up, you know, stay and build up his units. He's going onward, so all right. Who might argue with the King of the Dwarves? I have damaged buildings to repair. Just move on. Oh, okay, here we go. This is a good battle. This looks about even. This is the underway interceptor. Do you wish to intercept the enemy forces involving the underground nearby? Actually, I don't have to. I could just let them go by. Is Grundadrak besieging? Oh, but they're trying to maybe get out of there, and I'm trying to besiege them. So, or do I just let them go on by? You know what, if I let them go on by, they might fight. This is better to take on one army at a time. So, oh, shoot, I pushed decline attack. Whoops. Oh, well, I guess I just let them go on. Yeah, I know. Oh, well, I'm trying to take over this thing, so I guess we're staying focused. Okay, can we breach here this turn? I think so. And by the way, and if we did a mountain movement, we wouldn't be able to get there, so...
I declare war on them!
Oh, couldn't quite make it? Oh, well, mountain movement would have still only brought us to here, so... Dang it, that's still annoying. Alright, how are we doing money-wise?
Summon me if you dare!
I want to at least have 10 before I go down here to try to defend this territory.
It is time.
So I'm just going to build one more of each of these. Alright. And then they'll go down to defend. Alright. Shoot, I hope I don't regret the letting those guys pass. Pushed the wrong button. Oh, yeah, rebellion. And they're going to go, of course, after that town that I just conquered. But that's alright, we're going to take this major city. Yeah, and they come around. I could have taken them in the underground and we would have had the advantage, probably. Okay, it's two armies. But if I take on one at a time, I might be able to beat them more easily. I'm going to go ahead and fight this battle. This will be the important one. Can we... because if we can defeat both of these, I think the city itself will be weak for the attack. Shoot, if I had hit that one army, if I had intercepted them, then it would have been one at a time, rather than taking them both on at one time. That's bad. It's kind of like, if you know the Civil War, McClellan had the chance to get Lee when his armies were divided before Antietam, and he didn't. And then Lee combined his armies, and you wound up with the bloodiest day in American history. Ah, a little American history lesson for you there, folks. But if we can win this, then we've, you know, stopped both of them. Okay, so one of the armies will be coming in here, while the other one is setting up here. So, we could put all the miners up here and hit them and then bring them up here. And bring the rest up there, but then they're coming out. Or we could put them right in their faces over here and just kill them as they come on while they're coming up. Yeah, you know what? Here's what we're gonna do.
Lord! Dwarf warriors! Miners! Locked and loaded.
Actually, we're gonna put him with them.
Take an aim.
Oh, whoops. Oh, okay, wait.
We demand blood.
Yeah.
Thunderous.
There we go. Alright. So 4. Be able to shoot them as they come on.
The clans unite.
Yeah, and they'll be ready to just plaster them as they come along.
Victory will be ours.
You're supposed to face that way. Alright. And the miners.
For the Karazhan Khor!
You know, I could put the miners up around here and just sort of... But you know what, then I'm dividing my army, and the whole idea is to make them divide theirs. So I'm going to put the miners over here to go around and surround them. Alright, I'm going to start the battle, see where everybody is. Okay, so they're up there. The other army isn't on board. There we go! Oh, I meant to put them at the edge. Oh, well. They're gonna move around the flank. I want you start shooting at them. You start shooting at them. You start shooting at them. I want them to at least take some damage before I go in at them. Okay, they're marching.
Thunderous!
Start shooting.
Reload! Vengeance! Kill them! For the ancestors! Understood, Lord!
Okay, they'll start taking damage first before we go in. In fact...
Dwarf warriors!
Okay, they're gonna start shooting at us, so let's go ahead and go on in.
Killers! Castle! Yes! For the Karen Anchor!
Yes!
Be it ready! The clans unite! Come on!
Alright. Well, they're gonna hit us with some of their cavalry, which can't be helped because we need the gyrocopters for that. I really need to start building up on that. But the problem is it's the buildings that I need to spend money on, and just haven't really been able to do that with having warriors. Oh, and here's the leader is just kind of leading everybody. I'm going to just let his aura kind of help everybody first. I'm not going to send him into battle, even though I gave him a lot of the... Oh, you know what? No, he's going to go back here. Take out them. And you know what?
Miners!
There. Because that battle is going to be done by the time they get in there. So the miners are going to start moving up here.
Those dwarfen legs! Quarrelers! Will do!
Okay, we've almost gotten this taken care of. We want them dead before they, before the other unit gets up there. So you guys keep on shooting there. Just a little message, range units are usually better against, larger sized units, so like cavalry and stuff like that, because they're big and easy to hit. Large targets.
Muster the throw!
Oh shoot, we're getting hit from behind. Dang it. That was not good. I didn't see it. I wasn't like, it was kind of like, where are they charging? And then it was like, oh crap. But we're still, you know, they'll turn around now and finish them off. Alright, so now I need to start turning these guys around because, in fact, actually, I think I'll go ahead and start bringing them around as well. So yeah, both of these guys. Kind of start coming over this way. Alright. You just go ahead and get them. Alright. Oh, I got a follower on Twitter. Nice.
Alright,
fine. Turn back around. Oh, hey, my leader's getting attacked from all different angles. That's not good. Alright, you guys, go kill them off. Because, yeah, we'll... Oh, you know what? And actually, let's bring these guys up here. This will be a better place from which to defend. The miners, meanwhile, well, I don't want them to get completely caught off guard. So, you know what? I'm going to actually bring them over here. All right.
Come on in, boys.
Because what I want to do is basically defend from up here. Defend against that. All right. Let one unit take them on. Everybody else.
For Grimnir! For the ancestors!
All right. I gotta change this guy's name because I always forget what his name is. What is it? Oh, hey, and also Opal Amulet. Plus two Japan. Just a second. Oh, I can activate it. Damage resistance. And, makes them unbreakable. Okay, so that's going to be important later on. Right now, he's just about to take on archers, so I'm not going to use the amulet right now. But yes, okay, so I'm going to need to find a time to utilize that. Okay, you know what? I don't want my leader chasing archers off the table, so I'm going to leave that to some warriors. And I'm going to bring the leader over here, because that's where we're going to be needing him. And you go ahead and chase these guys. And you guys, alright, fight them off.
We're off!
Alright, bring these guys back here.
For the Karazankor!
We need this finished off very quickly. Oh boy, they're getting close. Oh, in fact, oh shoot. We got smacked by some guys over here. Alright, it is time for the miners to get into this. Move up. Yeah, just at least move up.
For the ancestors!
Start firing.
Fire at them!
What do I need? Okay, so this has to end over here. Dang. This is gonna be too late. Boy. They're going to be hitting us pretty hard over there. Okay. So don't run off the table. We're going to need you. In fact, actually, come on over here. You know what? I'm going to bring these guys over to join over here as well. These guys over here might get destroyed. This is going to sort of suck, but I hate to do it. Are there any of our top guys? Attack, inflict, damage sustained. Okay. They're tired, but yeah, they have to finish this whole thing off. Guess I can send these guys to defend against the oncoming horde, so they don't get a full destruction on us. Meanwhile, okay, they're about to get hit by them, so let's wait up there. Wait, did they just stop? Oh, good grief, and the leader's gonna get attacked here. Good grief. Come on, run off the table, run them off the table. Oh, seriously, now they're gonna come back and fight? Oh, erg, this is frustrating. Oh, shoot. I thought they were going to attack the warriors there. Alright. It is time for these guys to come rushing in. In fact, actually, I think I might just need to run them in. Because I know it'll tire them out, but they're going to be out. The battle's going to be over if they just walk in there, because dwarves are so slow! Guys, just get back in line, start shooting. You just shoot, yeah. Go ahead and shoot at them. Why are they still there shooting? That is a problem. They have to be in line here. We have to hold this. Alright, you know what? Just go on in there.
We will have vengeance! Move off!
Oh, I see, just in one unit. Whoop, Zoom battle. Ah! I wanted... Here, just a second. Hold on, pause this. Forget it, I don't want to use that right now. Didn't, I thought it was going to be everybody within the aura. Oh, here we go. All right, go ahead. Go on in there. You guys are already fighting right here. And you guys are fighting there. That's good. All right, and we've made contact over here. Run right through there. Let one guy take care of them while the others go off after that. All right, that's good. Okay. He's gonna actually run over, leader's gonna run over here so he can start giving his aura to, or start giving his, Alright. A lot of good fighting going on. A lot of good beating up. What's going on over here? Looks like we have the leader. Okay, let one continue chase over there. Then, well, you know what? No, screw it. This guy, because they're close, will go after the leader. These guys will continue to chase after them. These guys will just chase after them. And same here. Actually, they're going to try to run through. Alright. Oh, we're doing good, actually. Okay, he is gonna go ahead and use his crown of command on this guy. Then he's gonna put the opal protection on himself and charge on in. That's what I designed him for, is to be an actual fighter. Not some pussy.
Get moving!
Alright, charge over there, because yeah, they have a lot of archers, so... I'm actually not even caring about whether or not I kill his leader, although it looks like I might, but I'm not caring about killing his leader, I'm just caring about keeping the leader occupied. Nice!
Get moving! Dwarf warriors!
Get in there! Now you kill him. I'm gonna call these guys archer chasers. Kinda like the ghost chasers, except the archer chasers. Oh yeah, and there's our fearless leader in there, just bashing the heck out of them. Nice! Grundadruck! Alright, keep going. Don't stop right in front of them. Just make yourself a target symbol.
Vengeance! Kill us! Miners! Kasuk! Down! Yes! Vengeance!
Kill them wherever they are.
Quarrelers!
We might, might have them finished off.
Kalox! For the High King!
Oh my god, do we have them all on the run? Just about. These are the only ones not running. Oh, and some of them over here. Oh, come on, finish these guys off. What the heck is wrong with you? Oh, and the leader's coming back? Alright, fine. Just kill orcs wherever you see them. Problem is they're so fast. Okay.
They have wronged us!
Yes, they have. For their sheer existence. Oopsie. Oh, no, no, no. Oh, dang it! Keep pressing the wrong buttons. Oh, one of these guys. Go after that. Where's our leader? Okay, our leader's over there. Chasing people off. Okay, come back and cut them off of the pass. Finish them off. Yeah, that's just one unit doing that, so yeah, go chase them off the board.
Dwarf warriors! Down! Kasuk! For the Karas Angkor! Dwarf warriors!
He used all his ammunition. Alright, who used his ammunition? Them? Alright then. Time for you just to go and kill something.
the Karas Anchor!
And
miners!
At this point, there's no strategy. I'm just like, find whoever you can see. Whoever you see first, and they just go kill them.
Reckoning. Dwarf warriors!
Oh yeah, just chase them off the board. Okay, you can run after them. Go run. After them, run. Even though they're much bigger, it's just like, it's just Archer. Just run. Kill them. Chase them off.
For the high king! Blow through!
Go! Yes! Go!
Pursuit! Pick your targets well!
See, and some of these guys I want to take off of what they're chasing, but it's like, they... Then they come back, so it's just like, ugh. Alright, chase them off the freaking board.
Shoot!
Ah, there we go.
Vengeance! Move off!
Nice. Alright, there we go. In the battle. Nicely done. So now... We took about 50% losses. That's not good. But we should be able to take the city. And we're pretty much out of time. So, let's see if we're going to be able to do it. Kill the captives. We are done being nice. Those queens can grudge. Raise the banners. All right. Rebellion, of course. Confederation between the queens. Oh, I thought they already were in confederation. Technology research. Interlocking shields. Oh, we just got that. All right. Plus four versus... Okay, Grudge Keeper. Oh, Dwarf Bride. Oops, he's got another bride. Nice. Ooh, nicely done. Here, let's take a look at him here real quick. Kind of jumped through that quickly. Dwarf Bride. Oh, was it a Dwarf Bride for somebody else before? Cooper, Dwarven Bride. Well, now he's got the Dwarven Bride and the Teller of Tales. Basically, he got it from the Orc City. Yes, run that place over. Now have it. Occupy it.
Yes.
Control of the province. Yes. Alright, anything that adds to defense, I guess probably public order, because this is what we're gonna want to do. What the heck?
Throw banners!
Alright.
Let's march!
Go take that. Ooh, we can just take it. Auto-resolve that bitch. Yes! Occupy!
Yes.
Oh, this is looking good, all these dwarven places. Ooh, and all that money. Yes. Alright, and... One thing we want to do... Wait, is this... Oh, here we go. Alright, here we go. Construction cost, growth, tax rate. We are running... But we actually have quite a bit of money. We want public order, so venerate the ancestors. And we have them coming down at us. We do have to rebuild our army, but... We also really severely need... to defend Barak Var. So, that's going to become the question for the next turn. There's one thing I'm not even going to ask here. This is one thing I really want to do. Because we need this in order to expand this and start building the Longbeards, which is cheaper for our king to build. And to start building up towards... Oh, and Thane. And to start building up towards gyrocopters. I forget how you do that, but yeah, we need another building so we can start building gyrocopters. We're going to also need to build up on here. Here's the next question, though.
Hi.
Okay, we have 10 of 20. Actually, do we start repairing now? Actually, yes, let's repair. So this isn't so much questions here yet. I'm just, repair cost, repair. Oh, wait, you know what? We can't afford it. Can't afford it yet, because look at this. Alright, we're going to be in bankruptcy, so we can't do that. But, we'll start making money here real soon. But, the big question is now, what do we do with our armies? Because we have actually gained this province, and we have this province. This episode has been basically about taking those two provinces. Now, we have to clean up the provinces. And we have Grundadrak right here. His army is kind of hurting after that big battle. do we let him recover and sort of build up his army before going back, or do we send him out right away? And then if we do go out, do we after, or either now or later, do we go after this army? Do we go after the rebels? Or do we go after this army? My point of view is this army is less important because, yes, he might take this, but this is kind of like my buffer city. In a way, I took that so that they would go after that and not after our main cities. But Barrack Vir is always a very important one. But you guys decide.
Stop that.
This army, this army, or this army. And that will be... That'll be Grendadrak's job. Then what do we do with Grudgebearer? Does he go over there to help them and clean up this territory, which is kind of what my vote is. But the other thing you could do is send him out to continue on. I mean, basically, if we do send him back to clean up, they might come back and take back Iron Rock. So do we have him defend Iron Rock? Do we have him go out and continue to take more territory? Ooh, who is this? Crooked Moon. Oh, no, that's these guys. Top Knots. Oh, it's another orc group. So it's like, you know, we could actually try to make Top Knots. Let's see if we can't Savage Orc Tribes. Let's see if we can't
Dantes, they dare approach me.
Okay, this isn't gonna work, but let's just try it for the heck of it. Yeah, okay. Alright, well, so of course, we aren't quite at war with them yet, so we don't have to, you know, start that up. But we could go down and attack them. We could go and attack Black Crag, which is part of the Greenskins. Or we can bring them back and start defending up here. We also have this army. Should we bring this down here to start defending here? Although, you know, we don't have them as much, put them involved in this whole thing. Or do we leave Dragon Slayer's army back up here? So this is Dragon Slayer's army, this is Grundredak's army, and this is Grudgebearer's army. Grundredak is definitely going to go. He has to clear his valley of these orcs. Does he wait? And once he does go out, which army does he go after? Do we send the Grudgebearer back up to his home? Does he help clean up here? Or does he go continue here? And the army that's up here under Dragon Slayer, does he go stay up here or does he go down there? That's up to you, my armed and stinky Senate. You make the choice. Make your votes. Tell me what you want in the comments below. Thank you all for watching. Oh, and one other thing here. We can call upon the old. The recruitment of Longbeard's units gets cheaper, which we're going to be able to build soon. Autonomy of the Holds, which gives us extra growth. That's actually what I vote for, but you guys choose. Thane's Authority, Hero Action Cost is less. Toolmaker, Income from Toolmakers, easier. Call to Clan, Unit Experience goes up faster. Actually, that might be the best one, because we do want to get that sometime soon. Oath Stones, Leadership is plus 5, and Ammunition Wagon or Masterworks, which are both 4 ranged. So you choose the technology, and you choose what the armies are going to do. Thank you for watching. Be sure to subscribe and tell your friends about it. We'd like to have a larger Senate, and happy gaming, everybody.